Yeah, so obviously as you can see, this is a new setup here. I've moved my studio. I'm gonna slowly create this space into where I'm gonna be filming. So I'm gonna slowly add new things into the background, all that sort of stuff. Anyway, let's get into today's video. So today, I wanna show you how to use a tone curve. So if you don't know what the tone curve is, it is this sort of, I don't even know how to describe it. It's like, if we go into light here and then we go into curve, it's like this, it's this line essentially, and there's RGB, which is your red, green, and blue, which is this one here. And then you have your individual one, which is your red, your green slider, and your blue slider. And I found out about the tone curve about 2 years ago when I first was starting to play around with editing. I was changing up my style, didn't really know what I wanted, but I saw some photos on Instagram and they had this really cool fade to them. And then I figured out that this is how you do them. You do that fade in the tone curve. And it's really quite easy. The way you do the fade is you just bring this bottom slider here and you just bring it up to the middle. And as you can see, it creates the fade. So all the blacks are gonna now be faded. Something like that. And I use the tone curve in all my edits today. The main thing that I use this first slider is I use it to create contrast in my photos. And the way you do that, the way you create contrast is by going to this top part here. You create a new tab just by clicking and you just bring that up a bit. And then you bring this bottom part here, create a new tab by clicking and you just bring that down a bit. And you want to create an S essentially. It's called an S tone curve. You've probably heard that before, and that just creates a bit of contrast. So as you can see, if we go before and after, there's just a bit more contrast and it's a bit more faded. And so now that we have the fade to the image, we want to add color to the fade, which is what I do. I add colors to the blacks of the image, which are now faded. So for my images personally, I like to have sort of like a blue cold vibe. So I like to have more blues and aquas in my photos. And the way you do that is you go to the red slider and you just create a new tab here in the bottom and you just literally bring it down. So as you can see, if I bring it all the way down, it's really, really blue. But we don't want it, we just want a subtle blue. So I do that by just bringing it back up a bit and just somewhere like that. Just so it's subtle, not, you don't want to over edit your photos, like, unless that's your style. Maybe your style is over editing and just completely saturating everything. Well, if it is, go ahead and do that. But for me, I like to have it sort of just simple, just a little bit of blue. But as you can see, this is a bit too, it's not blue, it's like greeny blue. And I want it to be like a nice cold blue. So I'll just go into my blue tab here and I'll just bring this up a bit to the left. Just like that, really, really minor thing. That's another thing. A really important tip for the tone curve is you wanna have really minor adjustments, because if you move it a little bit, it can create a lot of color. So you just wanna keep that in mind. Only move those little tabs a tiny bit. That's all you need. So I might add a little bit more blue here, just something like that. But yeah, that's pretty much it. That's how I use a tone curve. I obviously, this isn't my editing. I obviously do a lot more in Lightroom to edit, but I just wanted this video to be specifically about the tone curve because I knew when I was starting photography, it was just this really difficult thing that I always got overwhelmed when I look at and I never knew how to use it. So I hope you learned something today. If you did learn something, maybe consider liking and subscribing to my channel because that's what I do here. My goal is to teach you guys and make you guys inspired so you can go out and take photos like I do. All right, so now that you've learned how to use the tone curve, I want you to actually go out and use it. So I want you to create this sort of faded edit on your next photo on Instagram and I want you to tag me in it. I'll go have a look at it and let you know what I think. But anyway, that's it for today. As always, stay inspired, keep creating, and I will see you in the next one.